just follow the logic that, I mean, to me, the initial logic was pretty obvious, that if we have the kind of technology that can go in there and repair 100 billion damaged neurons and all the other cells in the body and can reverse the aging process, if we have that kind of technology, then regrowing a body should be pretty trivial by comparison. So that doesn't necessarily imply uploading. That's just, I think, a recognition of the logic of the kind of repair technologies we'd need. But I would guess that certainly more neuro members would be sympathetic to the idea. But that is just a guess, and I would be interested in carrying out that survey. I think there would be something interesting to find out. I'll make a note of it.
And sorry, Max, since the connection to Facebook went down and I think Randall lost your answer, I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to repeat your point. Now Randall is listening again.
Oh, okay. So the answer was, I'll try to say it more concisely, no, we haven't carried out such a survey, but I suspect that a larger percentage of our neuro members would be sympathetic to the idea of uploading than would our whole body members, but I don't think there'd be a clear division. The reason being that I think many people who signed up for the neuro option, including myself back in 1986, my reasoning was that the kind of technology we need to repair a damaged brain and, you know, 100 billion neurons, and to reverse the aging process, if we have that technology, then regenerating a body is trivial by comparison. So why waste the money in taking along the rest of the body, especially if it's much more expensive? So yes, I think in general it's likely that more neuros would be sympathetic to the uploading idea. I don't think it would be, you know, a very clear correlation. But I am interested in carrying out that survey. I think actually we should be doing more surveys of our members on these kind of questions. I have a question for Ken, if I may.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Yeah, since the last time I saw you in person, Ken, it was at the conference in Tucson. I don't think we had a chance to talk about this, but do you see this question of, you know, the idea that microtubules are crucial for consciousness? Do you see, first of all, do you think that's remotely plausible? In its very small position, minority position among neuroscientists, as I understand it. And if you do see it as sort of plausible, do you think that's a problem for cryopreservation, you know, where it's the way it's